Happy Halloween, everyone. I've been holding this kit back. We got it a while ago. We showed it on the new kits video. I wanted to wait till this weekend, the weekend before All Hallows Eve, to build up Polar Lights 1/25th scale Undertaker Dragster. This thing is so cool looking. Comes with a nice little diorama base you're going to see in a moment. Tells you the history of Carl Casper. It just is so cool looking. Though once I open the box, I realize this is not a kit for the beginner. If you like collecting model kits, go ahead and grab it. If you like building these drail dragsters and customs, that's awesome. If it's your first model kit, don't make it your first model kit. It's very, very fiddly. We're going to see that. It's got a lot of stuff in here. I also want to let you know that this is a really cool, and this is a real car, the Undertaker Dragster. Like it says, it was won over 200 trophies and is the greatest yet. This wild dragster is the NHRA National Sweepstakes Champion and is undefeated in competition coast to coast. So you can build it exactly like the box art, which is the only color reference they have for the kit. You can look it up online, or you can build your own version of this cool dragster in your own colors, in your own way. That's the great thing about when you buy a model, you get to make it your way and no one else's. So let's take a look at all the cool stuff that'll be in the box when you get it. First up, we've got a set of two drag slicks in the back. Very vintage looking with the little lugs on the side, the smooth. We'll sand those down. Those will look great. And then we have some skinnies for the front end. And I'm glad these are provided in the rubbery vinyl instead of solid plastic like sometimes they are. We've got a teeny tiny sheet of decals here. We got some cool red eyes. We got Undertaker logos, Carl Casper signatures. We got Undertaker signs in the green and the white for the like the Banshee or the Undertaker logos. So it's a small decal sheet, not a lot on there, but it will enhance the model. The instruction manual on this one's one that I wanted to show you because it's so vintage cool looking. A lot of words. Love the old ad for the styrene cement. Fireproof styrene cement. You can see the chassis will be very, very fiddly to put together. So I'm going to do as much of it as I can on camera, but there's going to be points where I just have to break free and work without a camera in my face. Even the body itself, multi-pieces, and we're going to see that in a moment. So let's take a look at the giant chrome trees. There are two of them, and they are full of teeny tiny parts. The chrome is well done, a little bit thick, but well done. We've got spoke wheels molded open. We've got the rear wheels here. This is our grill. I assume these ovals might be where those eye decals go. Not sure, but we'll find out. Got our front axle, all the different radius rods, roll bars and supports, dashboard, steering wheel. So you can see how very, very fine the parts are, how very small they are. The entire engine is made out of chrome. The differential is. The headers are one piece, which I'm surprised in this kit since they broke down everything into teeny, minuscule parts. The windup on the back is cool. One large chrome piece. So I will super glue a lot of these parts together and end up painting them instead of trying to sand off all the little areas for cement. We've got a small piece of glass. That's for the moon sunroof glass on the top of the roof. There is no windshield on it, but it does have glass up there so it gets light inside the cab so you can see it. On the other side of the table is our multi-piece body. You can see where that window goes in there, the cool texture on the roof there. Our interior pan, which is so loose I'm going to break off now. Tufted interior, looks really cool. It's even got the seat molded in with seat belts. You can see them down there. The rest of our body, the sides, we've got a tombstone here. We've got part of our cab. So a lot of small details on that. Very delicate model. That's why I'm saying I wouldn't make this a first-time model. We've got figurines. We've got some skeleton heads. We've got the Undertaker head. We've got, looks like, white wall inserts for those tires. Even though on the box art, they are black wall. These certainly look like white wall inserts, and they would fit in there perfectly. We've got the Undertaker body. We've got the ghost that stands off to the side. And when I say stand, I mean stand, because this kit comes with a diorama base. Really cool diorama base. Like they would have displayed it at car shows and stuff. We've got a base for what I think is the tombstone there. We got some little ringlets here, probably to hold things together. And then we've got a bat. A cool bat. All kinds of awesome stuff in the Undertaker Dragster, building it up for the Halloween build. I'm going to start gluing mine together and you can watch me do it.
We'll be right back.
Now, as you could tell, that assembly session took much longer, and that's because this kit is quite fiddly. I'm also using a lot of super glue because I don't want to sit and sand down every single part, so I use super glue and a little activator, and that locks everything together. So the super glue is the bottles and the jelly you see me using, and the little pipette has super glue activator in it. That's how that works. It just instantly sets the super glue where it is. So on a lot of the chrome parts, you'll see clouding because I plan on painting the frame and the engine and the blower. I'm not worried about any sort of super glue clouding and making it look bad because it's going to get a coat of primer and a coat of paint anyways. Parts of chrome that I will be gluing together that I don't want to cloud up, that I want to stay chrome, of course I take much more care on. I glued the front wheels together, and as you can see, there's no clouding. They look nice. We'll be able to slip our tires on there, and those stay the way they are, so those won't be getting any paint. And then like the moon tank, I want that to stay chrome, so I glued it together very carefully, clamped it, and now that doesn't have any clouding either. We got all kinds of stuff on here. I've got the Undertaker himself, which will go in the base, so we'll get to do a little bit of figure painting. We'll also get to do a little bit of figure painting with the ghost and its skull face there, and all that stuff will attach to the cool diorama base. I will glue it in place when it's done. Off to the side, we'll have the little pad here with the headstone announcing the name of the Undertaker vehicle with whatever decal we choose. And we can attach the bat there. We can, you know, put it wherever we want. But since the base is kind of open, we can always put the bat on the base there and use it and enjoy it. This part here is the air scoop for the blower. You can see that little inset there. I'll be painting that the same color as the body, so I'm leaving it on its tree. I can paint it and then cut it free and glue it onto the supercharger at a later point. The interior will just slip in to the body. You can see how the body fits on here. We have to slide it off backwards to get it rid of the... I included the gauges. I glued them in from the back. They're just chrome, and I can, since they're prominent, I can easily redab some chrome marker on there instead of having the big chrome blob back there. We'll get this all painted one color. Then we will carefully drop in, and we have to spread the interior a little bit to fit around the dashboard. So it's a very tight fit, but you'll see it will go in. And then all of that, it's a tricky fit. It's impossible to do while sitting here on camera, but you can see the roll cage will fit around those little swoopy back, so that kind of makes it look like a bat wing in there. That will drop down. The body will sit on the squares of the rear axle. The body glues together quite nicely. That's where those cat eye piece of chrome will go. In the back, that piece will fit right in there, and then we can put our decals on it. And then the grill, of course, goes here. And then the firewall will attach here. So we'll have a chrome firewall when we get all done, and I'll be careful when I glue that in. So that is that, and then there are numerous chrome parts that I'll do later. The roll cage support, the steering wheel, the steering bars, those all leave chrome. The fuel lines, the wheels, the knockoffs, those I'm gonna leave chrome on the car, as well as the cylinder heads, the headers, The supercharger air pipes will be blackwashed. I'll possibly paint these ends as well, but otherwise I want that to stay chrome when we attach those from the engine to the supercharger. The windup in the back will stay chrome, all that kind of stuff. Just little small parts I will be attaching later. So we got the body together. Now, of course, you could sand those seams and deal with them. I'm not going to. That's, you know, I build quickly and for fun. We got our top here. That should attach and just lay right over the top, like so. So we'll get that painted so it doesn't look like white plastic. It'll still be white, but it won't look like white plastic. We got this hand, this disembodied hand, and the two heads. The instructions say you can put the hands and stuff on the interior. See, like attach the hand to the shifter, and then put the skulls and stuff like that on the side. but you can attach them anywhere you want. You could put the skulls on the brake lever and on the shifter, or you could just attach them around the base or whatever. It's pretty much whatever you want to do. If you just want to leave the shifters with their steel rods, so, you know, whatever you want to build your vehicle as, to replicate the Undertaker perfectly, you'd want to put them on the shifters and all that stuff and make it look just like the show car. We got the engine and the blower, which are all chrome and completely full of glue to hold them together so I can paint them a metallic tone I like more. I don't want them to be the same exact metallic tone. They're going to go together like so. And I want these to be painted two different tones. Same as the frame. I want the frame metallic, but for me, trying to glue all this chrome together and all that stuff, I move pretty quick and it's still fiddly for me. So I've got it all set up. I've got the wheel retainers in the back, and I got the motor mounts on here. I got the chassis glued together. This is going to get a nice shiny metallic tone with spray paint, and that is it. It takes a little while to get together. It is fiddly, but it does lock together quite well. But if you want to do it precisely, you're going to have to sand chrome off and use model glue and stuff like that. This little white piece here is to mount a skull on the front of the car, which that I'm definitely going to do. So I'm going to get everything into paint. And there's one other tip I wanted to give you in this session. And that is, when you're using a lot of super glue, you're going to get it on your fingers. And there is an easy way to remove it. You can get super glue deactivator, which costs a small fortune. And it's pretty much just acetone in a bottle from the dollar store. You can get 100% acetone, drip a little bit on your fingers and rub it off. Now that works, but acetone is toxic, and you know, you buy a big jug of it too. I just use this and it lasts forever from the dollar store. What I like, what removes super glue the best for me, is just a sanding sponge or a piece of sandpaper, and I just sand my finger off. You can see the white glue comes off. It's impossible to hurt yourself, because if you can hurt yourself sanding your finger until the super glue just reaches your skin, you can also cut your arm off with a handsaw. So we got a little super glue there. Just rub it. If it starts to hurt, stop doing it. You've reached skin. And that takes it off super easy. You don't have your hands rubbed in nasty acetone, and they will come out just fine, and then you can actually feel and hold on to things again. So that's a quick tip and trick from someone who doesn't like pouring. I use so much super glue, I don't like pouring acetone on my hands unless it's a bad mess. Then I use acetone to get it off and soap and water to clean itself. So we're going to get all this stuff over into the paint booth, and I'll see you over there.
Thank you. Thank you.
I've got very, very little to do before I wrap up my build of the Undertaker Dragster, my own interpretation on it, my own paint techniques and assembly techniques and ideas for it, but still pretty close to the original. We got the bases all together, so in this build, you know, you buy a model car, and on top of it, you get to do two figures, a diorama base, and a little sign display for the Undertaker Dragster. We got our top here with the clear glass. That's going to end up sitting on the back of the dragster like so. I will attach that. Then I will give all the chrome and the paintwork a coat of future floor polish, a very light, careful coat, because I don't want to get any on the tires. The wheels and everything friction fit. The front wheels I did glue into place. We've got the Undertaker himself with a little bit of green skin like the box art and his purple grayish suit, his cloak like that. We've got him there. We've got the more ghostly ghoul with almost no gray, mostly purple and blacks, and then washed in there with his skeleton face. We got the skeleton head on the front and on the gear lever there. So once this is closed up, you won't be able to see inside. That's why I wanted to show it to you now. You can take a look at that interior. I did it like the box art, like a pinkish reddish. Green belts in there, got our steering wheel, got our tachometer. What I'm going to do is use the green Undertaker decal across the back of the car. I think that'll look good. And then I will use the black and white Undertaker decal on the tombstone as the little sign. So we've got our sweet looking hot rod. You can see underneath, mostly metallic work and everything. We got our headers in chrome, our valve covers, our tubes for the supercharger. We got our two different tones on the engine. Then we got all our little plumbing and everything from the moon tank to the front of the supercharger for the fuel and everything. So those are neat little features since it's all exposed. We've even got our little crank on the back. That's just so cool. So many little tiny details. A little intimidating for the kit to build. It is kind of fiddly. We also got those cool white walls. Now on the box art and on a picture of the real one, I did not see the white walls. So you could just turn those tires to the opposite side. I wanted the white walls on mine. I've got the lighter color interior. I just like that look with the white top and everything. This is model railroading or gaming detailing fabric with grass tufts. Now you could just paint the base and set the car in it and it's going to look really tough. I mean, that looks tough just as it is. I want to take it a little bit further. It's Halloween. Oh, I'm throwing stuff all over here. I want to put this base on here. So all I'm going to do is measure the base, which is a perfect rectangle. You know, it's not off angle or anything like that. And then just cut the base out, glue it in there, and then we will set our car on top of it. Apply the decals that I want to use, definitely using those tail lights. I'm not sure what else I'll use on the car. And then as you saw with the car, I did that fluorescent paint over the metallic just so we get that varied texture to everything. So these figures will get glued into place. The base will be set on the side. The little bat is glued into place on top of the tombstone. That's weathered and mossed up, and so is the base. And when I come back, we'll have that final. Well, how ultra groovy is the Carl Casper Undertaker Dragster 1/25th scale model kit by Polar Lights via Round 2 Models? They sent over this beauty and we've got it together. It is a time-consuming, finicky, small part kind of a build, but it builds into a really cool model with its own diorama and figures and nameplate and everything. The only thing added to this kit that wasn't in the box was this simple, inexpensive mat that you would use for model railroads or dioramas like this or whatever you want. The base definitely needed some grassy area and stuff like that, the scraggly soil you'd see in an old ignored cemetery. I've got my decals on the back, the cat eyes and the Carl Casper logo. I had a little bit of a paint boo-boo on the back and I didn't have time to strip the body and redo it. And I had that decal in that awesome green and yellowish. And then I did the fluorescent accents around the metallic lime ice, so the sign looks really great back there. It identifies the car. It fits right between the two seams there. We got our cat eyes, our little wind-up. We got our big honk and supercharged Hemi with that blower in the front. This is the second model I built this year with a blower sitting off the front of the engine instead of on the top. I built that old Revell dragster, and that had that as well from Atlantis, and now Polar Lights comes out with the Undertaker dragster, and it looks cool. I love these kits with a lot of history, very vintage box style. We've got the cool ghost and the Undertaker himself, the little bat that I glued on top of the headstone, and that base. I just think it's such a cool combination. There's so much to do with this kit, and you can do it your own way. You can build it how you want. You could build it with the roof off, paint the interior different. Just because the box says it's one way, and the original car had that cool three-tone faded paint scheme, doesn't mean you have to do yours that way. That's the thing. This is your model when you get it. You build it as you want. You decorate it. The one didn't have white wall tires, but they're in the box, and I like them like that. I like that seam down the tire, too. It's not a pushed-out seam, and it's an indented seam, maybe to make them DOT legal. I don't know. But anyways, cool kit. If you take your time and let the glue dry as you assemble things, you won't have much of an issue. But it is a little finicky, so I don't recommend it for a first-time builder. But if you can follow the directions, take your time, not get frustrated, start throwing things against the wall. You'll be able to get all the little parts, all the little fuel lines and stuff like that. With this being so prominent, you could even wire the engine. You could even put a completely different engine in here and save this thing for a boat or something else. It's your model. That's what I want you to express, because I know the comments will be full of, well, that's not the correct paint job of the Undertaker Dragster. You know, I was there in 19... And it doesn't matter. Build your model so that you enjoy them. And I wanted it in lime ice with a little fluorescent detail reminiscent of the body. And then I replicated slightly the pink, the rose interior with the red buttons in it and everything, because that I did like. So build your model your way. Have a lot of fun. We thank Round 2 Models for sending this over. What a cool reissue. Such an interesting kit with so much going on. Happy Halloween to everyone. That's why I saved this kit for so long. I wanted to make sure it was a Halloween season build. And we've got Halloween coming up on Monday. So enjoy yourselves. Pig out on those Reese's pieces and candy bars. And I will see all of you at the next review.